There's no vibration in the table, but boy, that penny is tapping. What mystery that wizard has. It's Jake Wizard 4 again from Faraday Studios, home of Midnight Science Club. It is good to be back with you. And we keep a place of honor here in Faraday Studio, right over there on the wall, Michael Faraday, a grand man. We always say, hello, Michael, how are you doing? Yeah. Born in 1791, used common objects all the time to express how science works to his audiences, and we're gonna do the same thing today. We're gonna use some bottles, normal bottles and jars, to do some elegant science activities. It will expand your understanding of the universe while you use all those bottles that are sitting around your house. So let's get started. So the first one to do, we need a chilled bottle, a coin that will just fit in the mouth of the bottle without falling in, and a little bit of water. That's all we need, right? Yeah, that's all we need, those three things. You just lay the coin in the mouth of that bottle, just so it lays flat and doesn't fall through. And then I'm gonna put a few drops of water, or any liquid will do, I guess, just to seal it, kind of make a gasket. Take your hands and wrap them around the body of the bottle and watch that coin. Ooh, something's happening. Did you see that? Oh, spirit of Abraham Lincoln, talk to me. Oh, tap. This is like Edgar Allan Poe or something. Tap, tap, tap. Who's tapping? Who's tapping on my bottle? What mystery that wizard has. He's not moving that bottle. There's no vibration in the table. But boy, that penny is tapping. So now that you've scared everybody with your mystical movement of this coin in the seance, there's some real science that's going on, of course. And it's very simple. Your hand is supplying some heat to this system right here. Heat from my hand warms the glass, and that warms the gas inside, and those molecules inside start to move around a little bit more, increasing the pressure and lifting up the coin. Tap, tap, tap. And that's why, of course, a chilled bottle will work a little better. Now, of course, a real scientist would want to think, yeah, okay, but where did the heat come from that's in my hands? Oh, from the blood. And where'd the blood get the heat? Oh, from the food I ate. And where'd the food get it? And it keeps on going and going and going. And eventually you'll end up, it all came from the sun. We just released some solar energy that was stored in my morning cereal. Isn't that sweet? Aha! I've got a lot of bottle activities. This is gonna be cool. So let's see what else we can do with a bottle. Here is another intriguing science activity using something you can find around the house, a bottle, right? And just watch this. I'm gonna set this bottle right here and move a candle in front of it. It's a special bottle. That's what I tell kids anyway. It's a special wizard bottle because I can blow right through it and put out the candle. You say, oh, that's not right, is it? Well, it's an old, old science trick. I think every science teacher in the world knows it. And just think about it. When I blow here, the ambient air pressure holds my breath up against the bottle in like a low pressure area as it moves across the surface of the bottle, and it's just held there. And it looks like it's blowing through the glass, but I'm really not. You make up your own story. Sweet. Hey, I wonder what would happen if I used a square bottle. What would happen? Well, I'll try it. And I want you to come up with your own tests. Maybe try two bottles. A milk bottle or a Coke bottle or three Coke bottles in a row. Can I blow through a square bottle? Same wizard glass. Oh, it worked when I got it diamond shaped. Oh, that's sweet. You may think I'm all done, but no, no. There are many more science tricks and activities you can do with a bottle. I wonder if I could blow through two bottles. Ooh, that would be sweet. I'm gonna try that. Who's the wizard? So I've got all the kids, the grandkids are all here at the studio, and they always want me to do a neat trick. I like to make them scream. And this is a good one. It's kind of a dirty trick, but it's kind of fun, and there's some science going on. Now I've just got a bottle laying here, right? Is there anything in the bottle? Do you see anything in the bottle? Yeah, there's air in there, so you didn't think about that. You gotta think like a scientist. And this is called a blow bug bottle. Now I just took a little ball of yellow paper and rolled it up, and I'm gonna set it right there inside the mouth of the bottle. And I'm gonna ask all the kids, and you too, how far do you think you could blow that little ball of paper? Do you think you could blow it and make it bang off the back end? Do you think you got big enough lungs to do that? First grandkid, ha! What? Oh, you got that stuck in there. What's going on? What? But, well, jiminy Christmas. What's going on? Well, think about it. What's inside there? Air. When I blow in there, I increase the air pressure. I increase it enough that it blows the thing right back out. Duh. Now, if you really want to scare the grandkids, get some yarn or some threads and I tied this little piece of yarn to make it look like a bug. I call this a blow bug. I said, does not like to be blown on. And I'll set it right in there. Do you guys think you can blow the bug back in the bottle? Oh God, you got me. Jiminy Christmas. Scared me to death. Now this is probably the simplest bottle activity I know, science related anyway. It's a sweet bit of science and you're gonna scare the heck out of your grandkids or any other victim that happens to walk by, and that's why I like it. In order to do this activity, you're going to need some water, a rubber band, some cheesecloth. There it is, cheesecloth. I got that at the paint store. You figure it out, cheesecloth from a paint store. What is that? But any loosely woven cloth should work for this. It needs to be clean though. And this bottle, this is a milk bottle. Now I know you don't know what a milk bottle is unless you studied ancient Egyptian hieroglyphics and you understand these ancient things. I grew up getting my milk delivered to the house in these bottles every day. Can you imagine that? You don't have to have an exact milk bottle, but any stiff bottle that does not flex, or so you don't, can't use plastic, something that'll squeeze. You need a hard with a nice smooth mouth on it like that, okay? So I'm just gonna take this empty bottle. It's got air in it, but that's the only thing it's got in it. And I'm gonna take the cheesecloth, stretch it across the top, and hold it in place with a rubber band. And there it is. A bottle full of air, cheesecloth. We call this special wizard one-way cloth. I'm gonna take this water, nothing special about this water other than it's clean, and I wanna pour it through this cheesecloth, hopefully. Let's see what happens. It's going right through. The water is going right through the cheesecloth, ladies and gentlemen, right before your very eyes. You can see it, it's barely restricting the flow. That's amazing. Yes, sir, I studied chemistry for 11 years, and this is what I can do. I know you're amazed, but watch this. You're gonna be amazed even further. I'm gonna take this bottle and I'm gonna turn it upside down. I want you to ponder for a second. What's gonna happen when the old man tips the bottle upside down? Let's see if you're right. I'm gonna turn it upside down. There it is. That's not right, is it? That water went through there so easily. It's not coming out so easily. What's going on here? And I'm gonna mess with your head even more. I've got some toothpicks here, little wood toothpicks. I'm gonna stick it through the cloth just to show you that cloth. Look, that toothpick just floated right up there. Look at that. There, did you see that? That toothpick went right through. The water isn't coming out. Now, why is that? Do you want the answer? Nod your head, please, if you want the answer. Okay. The answer is something called surface tension. Water molecules are attracted to themselves. And if I would hold this up and look real closely, I can't do it here, but if you look at it when you do this, you'll see the water is hanging down like little bulges, like little raindrops about ready to fall. Those water molecules hang on to each other just enough to keep it from falling out. And if you want to do a dirty trick when you do this activity, you hand it to somebody else, put a little dab of soap on there. It'll break the surface tension and all the water will come out. But I don't want to do it here because I'll get it all over myself. But anyway, there's another trick you can do with a bottle and you'll learn a little bit of science. I hope you learned how to think like a scientist while we messed around with simple things like these bottles. Join us on all sorts of social media. You'll find us there, Midnight Science Club. An old man wizard doing science activities with bottles. Sweetness. I think I'll move up next time. We'll go from bottles to pans. Fancy bottle. I bet I could do some really neat stuff with that one. I'm out of space. I'm taking this one home too. This is an ancient milk bottle. Find one of these, it's a special deal. We're done. We're out.